Hello friends, welcome to Learning by Fun. So we are continuing with our lecture on CLR parser. As we already discussed about what is LR1 items, okay? So in the last video, I have discussed about the LR1 items. So please refer to my last video. And now in today's tutorial, we are going to discuss how we are going to construct the parse table for the CLR parser, okay? So suppose we are having a grammar, okay? Where the first production is S derives your AA and A derives small a capital A and your A derives small b. Okay, these are the three set of productions given to us. Okay, and now we are supposed to find out the CLR parse table for the given set of productions. Okay, suppose this is a grammar G. Okay, so what we need to do now, we have to construct the augmented grammar. We need to form augmented grammar. Okay, so we need to form the augmented grammar. Okay, what will be the augmented grammar? Augmented grammar, as we know, will contain one extra production. Okay, that will be your S dash derives your start symbol, that is S. So S dash derives S. S derives your AA, your A derives small a capital A, and your A derives small b. Okay, so this is our first step. In each and every question given to you, you have to first find out the augmented grammar for the given production. Okay, so after finding this augmented grammar, okay, now we have to find out the LR1 items. Okay, now we are going to find out the LR1 items. So here we are going to find out the LR1 items. LR1 items we are going to find out. Okay, so when we are going to start, okay, as we know, LR1 item will be equal to LR0 item plus look ahead. Okay friends, LR1 item will be equal to LR0 items plus look ahead. As in the last tutorial, I already discussed about this look ahead. Okay, so please refer to my last video if you find any difficulty understanding this. Okay, so now we are first taking the very initial production of the augmented grammar, that is S dash derives S. Okay, as we were doing in the LR0 item in the SLR parse table, we will repeat the same procedure here also. We are just putting a dot before this S. Why? Because initially we have scanned nothing. Okay, so we are just putting this dot marker so that it will indicate how much we have scanned, how much symbol we have scanned in the given production. Okay, so initially we have scanned nothing. Okay, now friends, as it is LR1 grammar, so we need to include the look ahead also. Okay, so look ahead symbol for the any initial production, okay, any initial production, or we can say for the augmented production, that is S dash derives S. Okay, every time for the augmented production, your look ahead will be dollar. Okay, so we are writing here dollar. Okay, so here after S, there is a non-terminal, that is S. Okay, so since it is a non-terminal, so as we know that we have to write every production which can be derived by this non-terminal S. So here S derives AA. So we are writing S derives A and A. Okay, and we need to write dot here because we have scanned nothing initially. Okay, now friends, as after this S, okay, we have to take the first of the remaining items, but after this S, there is only dollar. So first of dollar will be dollar itself. So we are writing here dollar. Okay, now after this dot, we have a non-terminal A, and A produces A and capital A. So we are writing here A produces your dot A and capital A. Okay, and now here what we are doing, as we are deriving the production for this A. Okay, and the rest we will take the first of it to find out the look ahead. So first of, so we are finding the first of A and dollar. Okay, so first of A and dollar will be equals to your first of A, and first of A will be obviously equals to your A and B. A and B, okay? So we can write here that A derives dot A having the look ahead A or B. As it is also deriving B, so we can write here dot B, and it will have the same look ahead as it is also derived from this same A non-terminal, okay? So after forming this LR1 items, now we are going to derive, or we are going to construct the DFA design, okay, for the given LR1 items, okay? With the help of this LR1 items, we will construct the CLR parse table, and for this, the construction of the CLR parse table, we need a DFA, okay? So now we are proceeding towards designing a DFA for the given LR1 items, okay? So after finding this LR1 item, what we will do, we are just, okay, let me write it properly, okay? So output of your LR1 will be your this S derives dot AA dollar, your A derives dot AA A or B, okay, and your A derives dot B A or B, okay, this much. Now this will be the your initial state, that is I0, okay? The output of the LR1 item will be treated as the initial state, the zeroth state of your DFA design. So we have taken the output of your LR1 item as the initial state of our DFA, okay? Now after this, what we will do, we will first scan your S, okay? When we are going to scan the S, then what it will do, it will have, we will having this S just derives S dot, because we have scan this S symbol. And friends, always remember that look ahead will is not going to change, means look ahead will not change, okay, after shifting, so it will remain the same, that is dollar, okay, this much for this. So named it I1, okay. Now we are having S derives dot AA, okay, so we are having another symbol, that is A. When we are going to scan this A, we will get a production S derives A dot A, and look ahead will remain the same, okay? And here after this dot, we have a non-terminal A, so we need to derive, okay, the productions being referred by this non-terminal A. So A derives dot A and A, okay, and your A derives dot B, okay? Now friends, what we need to do here, as this production A derives dot A and A is the result of this non-terminal, okay, and after this there is only dollar, so first of dollar will be dollar itself, so we will write here dollar and dollar, okay? So this much, named it I2, okay? After this step, what we will do, we are having a symbol A, okay? So when we are going to scan this A, we will get A derives A dot A and A or B as look ahead, okay? This much, okay? And we need to expand this also. So A derives your dot A and A, okay? This will remain the same, A or B, okay? And your A derives dot B, and here it will remain the same, okay? This much for your I3. So after this, we are left with another symbol, that is B. So when we are going to scan this B, we are getting A derives B dot, and we will get the same look ahead, so name it as I4. So after this, we are having this 5 number of states, but still we are left with some symbols, because when we will stop, the stopping condition is that when we are having a dot to the rightmost side of every production, but it is not happening, so we need to expand more. So when we are moving this or scanning this A, okay, so we will get when we are moving this A, okay, so we will get S data is A, A dot and dollar, okay, and your, okay, this much, no, okay. So when we are going to scan this A, we are having this, okay. Now when we are going to scan this small a, we will get your A data is A dot A, okay, here it will be dollar, initially it will be dollar, okay. After this, A derives your dot AA, because for this, after this dot we have a non-terminal, so we need to expand this. So we are having a dollar here also, and now A derives dot B, so we are having a dollar right here. This much, okay. Now, when we are having B, okay, for B, we are having another state, okay, for B. For B friends, we are having a state A derives B dot. A derives B dot. We are having another state A derives B dot. Okay. And we are having a dollar over here. Okay. So, this is for this state this much. Now we need to expand this state also. State number I3. So, after expanding this I3, we will get, when we are having a scan of A, we will get your A derives A, A dot with A or B as your look ahead. Now, when you are having, okay, this much, okay. When you are having a scan of A, okay, small a, you will return to the same state. And when you are having a scan of this B, you will come to this state. Okay, this much. Now, okay, so after this, what we need to do? We have to do a scan of A. Okay, so after dot A is left, so we are scanning with A. We are getting A derives your A, A dot with look ahead dollar. Okay, this much. Okay, and when we are going to have a scan of A, we will reach to the same state, because A derives A dot A, and we are reaching to the same state on transition of A. And on transition of B, we can move to this state. Okay, on transition of B, we can move to this state. So after this, we can name the state as I1, I2, I3, I4. Name it as I5, here I6, here I7, I8 and I9. So after successful construction of your DFA design, we are having the 10 number of states for your CLR parse table construction. Okay, a very important point, my friends, that in SLR, okay, we are having less number of states in a DFA design as compared to your DFA design for your CLR parser. It is because we are performing, okay, based upon some certain look aheads, okay. So in the next tutorial, I will do your parse table construction, okay. I will perform the parse table construction using this DFA design, okay. For the timing, stay tuned to learn it by fun. To like, share and subscribe my channel. Bye bye.